So we ran our simulation, and just as a demonstration here, I'm going to show how we can load the simulation into the SketchUp plugin. The path is filled out for us because we just ran it. It takes a few minutes to load in here. It's loading a external SQL file. I'm going to request as a variable the outside surface temperature. And I can do zone or surface variables. And we have other tutorials on this if you want to get more in depth. This is just a quick demonstration. It takes a minute because it's loading this data in. I'm going to click apply. And when I switch rendering modes, it'll take a little bit of time to load. And this is time series data. So this is at 5:31 in the morning. Let's go when the sun's come up. Let's turn on shadow so we can see that a little better. Afternoon, we can see a lot happening here. Okay, so what's happening? Sometimes the windows, of course, will heat up quicker and then cool off quicker, so we can see the difference in temperatures. We have 25 Celsius and 59 or 55, 54 on the roof. So it's a nice diagnostic tool, and you can do zone level data. But anyway, that's not really relevant for the specific things we're going to do now. So I'm going to go back to this rendering mode, and in fact, I'm going to go back here and go into Results Viewer. So this is going to launch a Results Viewer application, and it'll load our SQL file. So on the left, we have a tree view or a table view, and we have all of our building surfaces. And this is different variables related to that. So I can look at the inside temperature for a specific surface and do a line plot. We have other videos here, but this shows the whole year, and you can zoom in. Or if you want to, you can actually do a flood plot, which shows time of day here and hour time of the year here. So this looks a lot like a roof. If I had an east-facing wall, it would be hotter in the morning and cooler in the afternoon. So you can tell a lot about the surface and how much it weighs and how well it distributes heat by the way this flood map looks. What I really care about here, though, is this. This is the annual building utility performance summary. And if I scroll down here a little bit, we can get end uses. So we have heating, cooling, interior lighting, exterior lighting. We didn't use interior equipment. And the rest of these are blank, but that's all we really have for this part. I'm going to leave this open and just minimize it. And we're going to go back into SketchUp for the next part, which will be in a separate video.